Bonjour guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to talk about the 5 things that you guys need to do before you even start your FE preparation. Now, if you guys like this video, don't forget to give us a big thumbs up so that we create more content like this. And don't forget to subscribe and make sure you guys hit the bell so you get notified each time we post new videos. Now, let's get right into it. Okay guys, so the first thing I recommend that you guys do is download the specifications and the reference manual. So because these two tell you exactly what's going to be on your FE exam. So take a look at the specifications, see what subjects is going to be covered, what you need to learn, what material is going to be on your FE exam. And then once you go over the specifications, then take a look at the equations that are on the reference manual and just get yourself familiar with the material. At this point, some of this stuff that's on the reference manual you probably know, and some you probably have never seen it or you just don't remember it. So this is going to give you an idea of what to expect for the next 3 months that you're going to be spending preparing for this exam. And then also it's going to give you an idea of what's gonna be on your FE exam. Now let's talk about tip number two. So tip number two is actually very, very important. So if you decide to not do any tips from this video, I recommend do at least number two. So tip number two is really just gathering all the material that you will be using to prepare for your FE exam. So one of my students, I actually interviewed her last week, Jacqueline, and she passed her FE exam after taking it 4 times. And she said the one thing that really changed for her this time around was the material. She really made sure that she had all the material for all the subjects that are covered on the FE before she started studying for the FE exam, because she noticed in the previous attempts, when she would sit to study, she would waste an hour looking for the material on YouTube and books and so on. And by the time she needed to start studying and learn the material, she was already too tired to do that, and she just lost motivation and she wasn't really consistent with her studying. So it's very important that you guys spend a couple days just really diving in and look for material that you will be using, whether that is books, courses, or videos on YouTube. And if you guys need help with resources, just let me know in the comments below. Now, the third thing that I recommend that you guys do is pick a dedicated studying spot. So a lot of my students have actually started using this method and they found it very helpful. The thing that you gotta be careful with is when you choose that studying spot, you gotta make sure that you do nothing there but studying. So you can't bring in your phone with you. You have to make sure that your phone is away from you so that way there's no distraction in case you get a text message, or if you are facing a hard problem, you're not gonna grab your phone and get on social media. It's very important that you guys set these kind of boundaries so that you stay focused when you are studying and learning the material. You also gotta make sure that nothing is open on your computer except your reference manual and maybe YouTube and Google if you are using those as resources, but you can't have Facebook or Instagram open again, so that way you don't get any notifications, and also avoid emails. So these are very important. They're really gonna help you guys to just stay focused. Now, having a dedicated spot or having a dedicated studying spot when you are going to sit there every single day, and if you the only thing you do there is studying, then your brain is just automatically going to be like, okay, this is the place where we study, right? And it's going to be easy for you to get into that mindset of studying when you get to your spot. Another thing that you can do is always leave your notebooks open and the reference manual open. That can save you at least 5 or 10 minutes instead of trying to each time bringing your notes out and then opening the reference manual. Instead, you could just have it already there, and then that way you see it, it will be an easy motivation for you to just sit and just dive in right into it. Now let's talk about tip number four. So tip number four is putting a schedule together. Now I already posted a video on this. If you haven't checked it out yet, I will leave the link above there. But in your schedule, what you can put is what you're going to study exactly. Like this, it can't just be math or static. That is very broad. You have to be very specific, like trusses or frames. And you also need to put material. What material are you going to use? This goes back to tip number two. This is why earlier I said tip number two is really important, because when you spend the whole week searching exactly what you're going to study or what material you're going to use, this is going to help you to easily start studying for the FE exam, because what you guys need to remember is, so the FE exam is overwhelming, right? It's stressful, especially if you've been out of school for a while, or if you have family and working full time. It can be hard to study for this test. So you have to make sure that you place in some study habits that's gonna easily or help you stay motivated and then also stay consistent. Because motivation and consistency are very important when it comes to the FE exam. So that's why putting a schedule and then researching exactly what you're going to use, the material you're going to use that's going to help you prepare, these two are going to easily get you motivated to start studying for the FE. Now, the last thing I recommend that you guys do when you start studying for the FE exam is make sure that you guys organize your notes per subject. So don't mix in math with quality and statistics, or dynamics and mechanics of materials. Make sure that you have your notes organized. So this way, it's just better for your brain. It processes the information better. And also, a week before your exam or the day before your exam, you can just review your notes and just skim through them. And that way, they are going to be organized. So it's easier for you to just recall the information and remember it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions or if there is a specific topic that you would like me to cover, please let me know in the comments below, and make sure that you guys share this video with your friends who might find it helpful, and don't forget to give us a big thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe for new videos every week. Thank you guys for watching. Good luck with your studying, and I will see you soon. À la prochaine. Oh yeah, everybody now.